while somebody else is doing other things. Right. Because, like, yeah, I've seen other streams use points, but what they use the points for usually have nothing to do with the stream itself. Right. So I feel like this, it actually, there's an interactive, and it makes sense in the context. It's not being shoved down people's throats. Right. And I like the idea that this, down here, the chat that you guys see on stream, it doesn't show anything that starts with an exclamation point. Like, you can see I typed that in there. That doesn't show, but that shows. So I may start converting more of the scare commands and the IRC commands to have the exclamation point in front of it. That way it doesn't bog down the chat on stream. So you can still see that and it would look nice and clean. Yeah, go ahead. And I'd said from the beginning, if my chat and scare and bot type things start getting too complicated, I may move all of the control away from chat to like a separate like control panel or something that I would post a link to. Downside there though is new viewers wouldn't see it and it wouldn't be as prominent. I just tried to copy and paste from my stream, from the video. Oh, that was funny. Yeah, so this is what I use. I'm using the OBS chat by Night Dev. So it looks like this is just extra CSS on top of it. Right. Yeah, but I always sort of said that once things get too out of control, I'll have like a separate little control panel. And that would also feed into, I don't know if you were here, Superbad Juju, did you hear about the potential idea to not only scare me, but also scare viewers? Right, that's the downside. So maybe we would keep a subset of commands, like the simpler stuff for the IRC and chat, and then the more complicated stuff would be moved to a separate control panel. Okay, so check this idea out. I'm really proud of this idea, and I think it's gonna be badass if we pull it off. So the idea would be that I would have a separate web page that I design that would have the Twitch stream, but it would have HTML and AJAX overlays on top of it, such that it would still use the same scare command roulette thing, but as commands, you could not only scare me, but you would have commands that would scare other viewers who decide to opt in as well. And you opt in by watching the stream on my personal webpage, not twitch.tv. So you still count as a viewer, you still get the chat and all that stuff, but you're just not watching it on twitch.tv. It would be a webpage that I threw together. So the scares would come in via chat, they would go out via HTTP socket calls to an AJAX client on the web interface, and it would scare the viewers using just overlays, you know, loud noises, bright flashes, any sort of stuff like that. And the really cool part of it is, like the next level interaction shit is, I would implement a flash client that you could opt in and allow webcam and microphone access. The webcam and mic would look for movement and sound, and if it detected that you got scared, it would send that chunk of video back to me that would then stream it into my stream live so that all the viewers could see all the other viewers who got scared. So like, let's say they type in a command that scares everyone, me and the viewers. Basically, not all at the same time because there's still a delay from video processing and stuff like that, but you'd see the scare happen, you'd see me get scared immediately, because on my side everything's synced up, and then like 5 seconds later, however long it takes, you would see like a grid overlay somewhere show up with all the other viewers getting scared as well. And I think that's like, you know, like layers of interaction with Twitch. There's like dude who's just playing a game, not talking to viewers. Level 2 is like dude who's very interactive and talks with the viewers. Level 3 is like the sort of junk I'm doing right now, like letting people directly interact with me, like not just talking, but like controlling lights, dropping things, sort of like breaking that fourth wall. And then the next layer on top of that is actually having the viewers be part of it. Like, not like playing games with them, like they are like part of the game, right? And it would be some pretty substantial code, because I'd have to write like a server socket to take that the video from the flash interface. I'd have to write the flash interface. I'd have to write all the AJAX and the HTTP web sockets. But you know, sharpen up them code skills, bro. Moving into dev anyway. I feel like that would be some sick shit if we pulled that off. And the nice thing is, like, if I add these things little by little, you guys sort of help out and hone it to sort of like, well, that idea was kind of cool, and this idea sucked, and... Like, in the beginning, I had as one of my scares, I had a laser pointer on 2 servos that would point directly at my forehead, and I thought that would scare me, but it didn't do anything, so I, you know, got rid of it. So that's the downside, Midwinter's Tomb, and I thought about that. And maybe what I'll have to do is the same sort of video approval thing. Like, it'll show up on my side, and I'll get a quick, like, GIF animation of the reaction, and I can just click on all of them to have them show up. Yeah, I know. That's the downside. I'd have to do, like, a real-time approval system. But even if it is delayed by, like, you know, up to, like, 20, 30 seconds, it would still be pretty darn awesome to be able to see that. And as a viewer, like, I'm trying to, all of the stuff I add in, I try and picture myself in the point of view of, like, what would I have fun doing? And I feel like if I was watching somebody play scary games and I could scare them with commands, how cool would it be if I could also scare all the viewers who opted in as well? Like, that'd be nuts. Yeah, I would definitely comment on it. Be like, well, you know, more power to you that you're that comfortable with yourself, but I'm not letting that stream out. Yeah, there would definitely be lots and lots of... The more interactive I make this, the more I'm opening myself up to trolling in general. So I'm going to have to constantly be thinking about ways to, like, hamper that. Because, like, right now, for example, if you type in, like, red, blue, white, green... I don't know, yellow, purple... It queues them up. So that queue is now sitting, waiting, so if somebody were to try and do a scare command right now, they'd have to wait until my stuff got done. But I'm working on the back end, threading this whole thing, so that certain things have higher priorities and can trump other guys. Oh, that's interesting. It missed some of them. I guess if it queues too fast, it doesn't even see the other messages. Huh. That's sort of a bug. Oh well. Alright guys, as always, if you guys think of anything awesome, send me a message now that I know I can receive them on Twitch, because they all get logged as spam for some reason. Thanks, Superbad. I'm gonna sign off for tonight, and it's still pretty early in the night. I'll probably start working on more junk with the bot. Alright guys, see you later. Thanks for watching. Goodbye!